Now coming to the second part of this chapter, of this prose. So, by now what happened? The school was off. Nishad and Maya were having holidays just due to heavy downpour, that means heavy rain. So Maya by now decided, she sat on her desk, study table, took a piece of paper and she started writing on that sheet of paper. What she wrote? I wrote in large block letters, catching a groog. Expert detectives Nishad and Maya Pandit by appointment to the whole world. Okay, so what she wrote on the piece of paper? Catching a crook. That means catching a criminal, Mr. Nag. Expert detectives, who were the detectives? Nishad and Maya Pandit. And appointed by who? To the whole world. That means now they were playing themselves as detectives. Then I began writing. About half an hour later, I turned towards Seven, who was lying on his tummy, chin up, curved in his palms, reading comics. So, the way Nishad over here is laying down on the bed is given in the picture. Okay, lying on his tummy, chin curved in his palms and reading comics. And Maya is sitting on her table. Want to hear what I have written? I asked. So what Maya said, that do you want to know that what I have written on this piece of paper? He looked up questioningly. I have listed all the facts we know about Mr. Nag, which might help us to trap him, I said. Want to hear? So what Maya said, that I have written, I have jotted down some points about Mr. Nag to trap him as a criminal. So do you want to hear, Nishad, what I have written? Seven nodded. Means he said yes. So fact number one, I read his name is Mr. Nag. We must discover his first name. What she said, that we know the name of that person is Mr. Nag. But unka first name kya hai? That we have to discover. Do you think that's his real name, Maya? Nishad asked. And Nishad ne kya bola? Ki, do you feel ki Mr. Nag bhi agar hoga to naam unka real hoga? Ye bhi ho sakta ki naam changed ho. Probably not, I said. Most crooks have an alias. I added a big question mark after Nag. What she said? That yes, maybe, probably not, because there is an alternate name of all the criminals. And what she did? She placed a big question mark after Nag. Fact number two, I read on. The tenants at Shankar House say he is mad, strange and unfriendly. So the people who used to live around Mr. Nag at Shankar's house, they used to say that Mr. Nag, the behavior, the nature of Mr. Nag, the personality of Mr. Nag is as he is mad, he is strange and he is not very friendly. He doesn't speak to anyone else there. Point number three, what she said, he doesn't talk to anyone and is mannerless. Mr. Nag doesn't speak to anyone and is not good in his manners. But he did talk to us, Maya, and Mama says he is very polite, Nishad interrupted. Nishad questioned Maya that when we met Mr. Nag, he spoke very politely to us. Mama also says that he is a very polite person. How can you say that he is mannerless? He only talked to us because he had to, I said. And since he was under Mama's medical treatment, he had to be polite. Maya ne kya bola? Ki bole, Mr. Nag is coming over to our mother for treatment. Mr. Nag mother ke paas aate apne treatment ke liye. That is why he has to be very polite with us. Okay, वो अपन से झगड़ा नहीं करेगा. वो उसको हमसे politely ही बात करनी पड़ेगी. So fact number four. He doesn't receive any letters. Seven nodded. Mr. Nag ko koi letters receive nahi hote hain. Nishad said yes. Number 5, he's been living in room 10 of Shankar house for more than a year, I continued. Mr. Nath, the address diya hua hai, that room number 10 of Shankar house. And he was living there from more than a year. Matlab saal bhar se zyada unko wahan rehte rehte ho gaya tha. Number 6, he doesn't work and sits in his room all day. He is not having any job to do, and he just sit in his room and do nothing. Number 7, the kids in Shankar house and even some of the grown-ups are scared of him. The people living in Shankar house, they were also quite scared of Mr. Nath. Number 8, he has no visitors except for a spectacle fair fat man who visits him on Sundays for lunch. Mr. Nath was not being visited by anyone. He had only one visitor who used to visit him on Sunday, who used to put on spectacles, who is fair and is a fat man. How they concluded that the person looks like? Nishad had talked about this with Ramesh. Number 9, food and tea are taken to his room by Ramesh from the restaurant downstairs. He doesn't care what he eats, pays his bill immediately and tips well. That ends my list. Have I forgotten anything, 7? Now, what she said, the last point was that Ramesh used to take up the meals for Mr. Nath, and Mr. Nath was least bothered what he is getting to eat, what is the menu he is getting to eat, but he is paying the bills immediately, not keeping any pending bills. He pays very well to Ramesh and gave good tips. And she asked Nishad whether she has not left any point. Nishad had obviously not been paying too much attention to my list of facts. All he could say was, poor man Maya, he must be so lonely, and if he doesn't have any friends. It was looking like Nishad was quite not interested about what Maya was saying all about. Okay, he was not paying much attention to what Maya was saying. But he had some thoughts and he said that poor Mr. Nath, that he is so lonely and he is not having friends at all. So how must he be surviving without friends? How can a crook have friends, idiot? I almost shouted. What Maya angrily said, that criminals ke dost kaise ho sakte hai? It's not possible that criminals would have friends. At least he has one friend, the one who meets him on Sundays, said Nishad. Nishad said, ek to hai, friends nahi hai, par ek to hai. So how you can say, jo usse milta hai aake Sunday ka, at least he is having one friend. A brilliant thought occurred to me just then. That man must be Mr. Nath, accomplice in crime, I said. Maybe he keeps all the loot and he comes now and then to give part of it to his partner, Mr. Nath, for expenses. That's it, I'm sure I'm right. Just after that, as soon as Nishad ne ye bola ki kam se kam ek friend to hai jo unko har Sunday aake visit karta hai Mr. Nath ko. And very soon Maya concluded that the person who used to visit Mr. Nath must be a helper in crime. Accomplice means a helper in crime. Matlab wo dono partners honge kisi crime mein. Mr. Nath and that visitor must be the partners in some crime, and that person used to come up every Sunday to Mr. Nath and give the amount of the loot which they had done. ओके तो पार्ट अपना कुछ लूट का पैसा देने आता होगा मिस्टर नाथ को. दिस वॉज बीन कंक्लूडेड बाय सो कॉल्ड माया, एंड बिकॉज ऑफ विच मिस्टर नाथ वॉज एबल टू पे सो वेल टू रमेश इन टर्म्स ऑफ टिप्स. If you insist on calling him a criminal, I don't think I want to discuss anything with you, Maya, said Nishad angrily. He can't be such a bad man if he gives Ramesh such generous tips. Now Nishad was very angry. He was completely standing against Maya's thoughts. The points which Maya was claiming, Nishad was standing against those thoughts. What he said that you do not keep on calling Mr. Nath as criminal. Don't call him as criminal because I think there is no point, there is no reason I should keep on discussing about this to you. Okay, and he Nishad also said that he Mr. Nath is not a bad man because he is giving good tips to Ramesh. So Ramesh probably knows something about his past. So Mr. Nath must be bribing him to keep quiet, I said. What Maya said, she gave back the answer. She said that Mr. Nath is paying Ramesh such good tips because it may happen that Ramesh must be knowing something about, some secret about Mr. Nath, and Mr. Nath must be paying Ramesh such generous tips because he wanted Ramesh to keep the secrets with him, not to tell anyone. So this may be the probability. This was being said by Maya. Nishan glared at me with his arms tightly crossed across his chest. I was beginning to get fed up with him. Nishad was now very angry. He was staring at Maya like anything. He has crossed his arms across his chest. Matlab haath fold kar liye the. He folded his hands to his chest and was beginning to get fed up with him. And Maya was now getting fed up of Nishad, that why Nishad is not trying to accept the points which I have written, which Maya have jot it down. How can we make any progress with our investigation if you take that attitude, Seven? What Maya said, that we cannot progress in this case until and unless Nishad is going to behave in such an angry manner. So this is not possible. We have to work together. I'll cooperate only if you give up this idea about him being an escape crew, said Seven. You really make me angry. So Nishad was somehow not very being satisfied that he was not trying to accept that Mr. Nath was a criminal. So on one condition, Nishad said Maya, that only on one condition I'll be working on this case, when you'll stop calling Mr. Nath as a criminal. You have to stop calling Mr. Nath as criminal because doing so makes Nishad angry. Okay? I almost hit him. I make you angry, you stupid oaf, I shouted. You make me mad. What is the point of all these inquiries if he is not a crook? If you think he is a nobody, what's the idea of bothering about him? Please tell me. So, Maya got very angry. Okay, what she said, that I am not making angry to you. You instead is making angry. Okay, you are making me mad. You are making me get angry on this thing. And what is the point of all these inquiries? Why we are making so much of inquiries about that about Mr. Nath, just to prove that he is a criminal? If you think he is nobody, what's the idea of bothering about him? Please tell me. And what she said, if you think that he is not a criminal, so give me the reason why he is not a criminal. What is the thing which is going on in your head and you feel like Mr. Nath is not a criminal? Nishad looked thoughtful. I would like to find out why he is so thin and why he is so lonely. I want to know why he doesn't have any friends and lives alone. Nishad said that I don't want to prove whether Mr. Nath is criminal or not, because I don't find him as a criminal. I want to inquire that why Mr. Nath is so thin. why he is so lonely and why he has no friends, why he lives alone. These are the points which Nishant wanted to work on. He was least bothered whether Mr. Nath was a criminal or not because he didn't believe that fact. Try to understand, Seven. I told him, if he has lived in Shankar house for a year and hasn't made a single friend, there's something wrong. He's obviously scared that someone will recognize him and give him up to the cops. What Maya then gave the excuse that you should understand, Nishant. Mr. Nath has been living in Shankar house, that must be the apartment. He is living there for more than a year and he has not made any friends over there. How is that possible? मतलब साल भर से मिस्टर नाथ शंकर हाउस में रह रहे हैं, उनके एक भी दोस्त नहीं बना. And every person living in Shankar house was scared of Mr. Nath. देखा जाए तो माया also said that it may be the probability that Mr. Nath is not making friends with anyone because he must be scared about कि कोई मुझे पहचान लेगा and they will hand me over to the police. Cops means police. Maybe no. Once tried to make no friends with him, Nishar protested. What Nishar said, ये भी तो हो सकता है कि कोई उनसे दोस्ती करना ही नहीं चाह रहा हो, किसी ने कोशिश भी नहीं करी हो उनसे फ्रेंडशिप करने की. Why should anyone bother? You have seen what a nasty bear he is, I said. What Maya said, that why anyone would try to be a friend of Mr. Nath? Mr. Nath looks so ugly, he doesn't look so good. I don't care, said Nishar stubbornly. I like him and I am going to try and be his friend. What's Nishar said that? I don't care whether anyone is his friend, why people are not getting, having a friend like Mr. Nath. Why Mr. Nath is not having any friend? I am not caring about that, but what I am willing to do is that I am going to meet Mr. Nath and become a friend of him. Friends with a crook? Huh, you are crazy, Seven, I said. The cops will take you to jail with him. Do you want that to happen, you idiot? Maya ne kya bola? Ki you must be mad. Tum ek criminal se dosti karna chahte ho? If the cops will find that you are one of the friend of Mr. Nath, then the police will come and they will catch you and throw you in the jail. So do you want this to happen with you? Nishar merely glared at me and quietly walked out of the room. My theory seemed to have made no impression on him at all. And by the end, Nishad was not at all accepting Maya's points, Maya's thoughts against Mr. Nath. Nishad was very strong with his views that Mr. Nath was not a criminal. Maya had a strong view of Mr. Nath was a criminal. Maya किसी भी तरीके से निशाद को insist नहीं कर पा रही थी कि Mr. Nath criminal है. Nishad was very firm in his thoughts that वो criminal नहीं है, he needs friends and I am going to become a friend of Mr. Nath. And he moved out of that room. Okay, मतलब माया की कोई भी explanations उस पे निशाद पे असर नहीं कर रही थी, effect नहीं कर रही थी. तो निशाद माया को ये लगा कि इसको कुछ असर नहीं हो रहा है मेरे बातों का एंड निशाद जस्ट वेंट आउट ऑफ द रूम एंड विद दिस द स्टोरी एंड्स.